Yesterday, we were looking into a switch case, a simple program wherein a program will accept a day number and display corresponding day of the week. Okay, and yesterday I think we were at here. We had given a case one. Here the label is what? One. Then we had also one more case whose label value is again same as the existing value. Then when we compile this particular program, let's see here. GCC switch. Dot C. Look at the error message here. Line number 18, there is an error. It says duplicate case value. It will also identify the case one and then previously it has used in this particular line. It will also display the corresponding case in the previous instance where it was used. So line number 13, it was already used and again you are trying to use the same case value in the line number 19. So let us go and check it here. See here, line number 13, we have already used the case 1, whereas in the line number 18, we are again using the case value 1. That's why we are getting the error here. So how we can solve this one? We need to have a different value other than what are the different, other than the case values which we have used here. So we can change it to 3 here. Okay, then go ahead and then compile the program. This time we will not see any errors. Okay, now. Sorry, is that understood so far, students, what we are discussing in the switch cases?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let us try to understand little more related to what break will do. So far what we have studied is that break means what will happen when this particular break statement is executed, the switch execution, right, means it will come out of this line and it will print what after this bracket. Let us say, let me add a statement here, say printf in the bracket, okay, end of the program, end of the program. If we have the slash n's everywhere, I have not written the slash n, let us use it slash n and slash n. What this slash n is called as? Just a quick recap.
Next line.
Yeah, we know next line.
Next line.
What is actual meaning of that one? Technical word. What slash n means? Anyone remember? Escape character. Escape character. This slash, the backward slash will give the meaning to be escape character. Okay, in one of the classes we will discuss further on the escape characters. Okay, now. Now, I've just added the one line and let us compile the program and see one of the output. Say, I will enter it to be a 4. It will display Thursday and then it is displaying end of the program, right? So how it worked? So we have entered the number 4 here and it has stored in the variable n. And switch n means what? The n value will be here 4. So that 4 value will keep on comparing with the each of the case values from the beginning to the from top to the bottom. So first one, it is a one value. So 4 is equals to 1, no. Then 4 is equals to 2, no. Then 4 is equals to 3, no. Then case 4, in this one, the value is 4 and the expression value is also 4. 4 is equals to 4. So match is found here. Means it will enter into the statements which are written inside this particular case. What are the statements written here? There are two statements. First one is printf Thursday. So we got the output to be Thursday here, we got the output to be Thursday. Then later, the second statement is a break. Break means what? Break the execution of the switch and go out of the switch, right? That means where does this switch gets completed? This is the opening bracket and corresponding closing is over here. So don't compare any of the values. That means what here? We have executed this Thursday and then there is a break. What it indicates is that don't go ahead and do any of the execution inside this particular cases, then directly go to the end of the case to all the switch statements. Now it comes over here and then we have another statement here, printf end of the program. So we display in the output, we are getting the end of the program here. Okay, I hope this is clear now. Now let us see here, what I will do is I will comment this break line. Comment means what? Will it be considered for the execution? Will this line number for 24 will be considered for the execution or no?
No, sir.
No, sir.
It's as good.
No,
as
sir.
Yes, very good. It's as good as we are deleting the line itself. See, it is commented here. Okay. Now, let us compile the program first. Compile the program. No error messages. Look at here. No error messages. That means what? If there is no break between in any of the case, we don't get any compilation error. Keep it in mind first. Okay. Next. Run the program. Let me enter the same number 4. I think I have commented it for the fourth case. Yes. Enter 4. Now, look at the output here. It has displayed Thursday. Then it has displayed Friday. And then there is an end of the program. Look at the difference between the output. This is the first instance where we had the break statement inside the case 4. Okay. And this is the another set of output where we have removed the break statement inside the case 4. What are we getting? What is the difference here? Difference is that there is one more statement getting executed. Which one is that? Friday. Which is the statement, corresponding statement here? The corresponding statement is what? Here. Then how come the case value was matched? See, if you go to the program execution, we had entered the 4 value. So this switch is having the n value is what? 4. So it starts comparing from the first case value, match not found, match not found, match not found. And here match is found. So it will enter into this case and then it will execute which line? Printf Thursday. Now, what are we getting the output here is that after displaying the Thursday, it is also displaying the Friday. That means what? It is going inside the next case also. It is going inside the next case also. And it is printing what? Friday. And after Friday, the next statement is what? Break. Break means skip the switch statement. So it has skipped the switch statement and then it has printed the end of the program. Okay. So is it understood so far? What is happening? I will explain why it is happening like that. Why? I will explain it later. But what is happening, you just understand it. Fine. Now,
yes, sir.
What I will do is that I will comment this break also here. I will comment this break also where inside the case 5, the break, I will comment it. Let us compile the program once again. Then run the program. This time again, I will enter 4. Now, look at the output now. Thursday printed, Friday printed, and then Saturday is also printed. Then it has came out of the switch and the end of the program is printed. So what is the observation we have here? Can anybody think of what is happening? Now, let me ask you another question.
Yes.
Suppose if I comment the break statement, which is present inside the case number 6, then what will happen? What may happen?
Case 7 also will be
print Sunday, sir.
It will print Sunday also will be printed.
It will also print Sunday, right?
Sunday.
We need to understand what is happening here, right? Why this is causing, why this is happening. Now, let us try to understand it once again from the beginning. So we had entered 4, match not found up to case 3. Then next, match is found over here. So the switch case mechanism, the comparison has happened here and it has found the match, right? So 4, the value in the expression is 4 and the label value is also 4. So 4 is equals to 4 is true, means the comparison part is done. That means now onwards, after this comparison become true, it will not validate the cases at all. I will repeat the statement, understand it. Once the comparison between the expression value and the label value, that is the case value, if there is a match found, means if both the values are same, then case comparison will never happen after that instance. Okay, that means what? When we had entered the 4, 4 has compared over here, it has come out true, then it has executed the corresponding statement. What is the statement here? Print the Thursday. It has printed the Thursday. After that, it will not go and check again It will not again check the expression value with the case value. Rather, it keeps on executing the next statements. Right? Initially, what has happened? We didn't have this. We had this break here. We didn't have a here also break was there. So what was happened? What was happening? Thursday got printed. Okay. And then after Thursday, it did not compare for the case five because already it has found the what match. Once the match is found, nowhere the comparison will happen. But instead of that, what will happen? The statements will be executed from top to bottom, right? So it has printed Thursday. After this Thursday, the next statement is what? This one. So printf Friday. Friday was also printed. After that, the next statement is what? Break. Break means now we're telling that explicitly you don't further execute break it here. Break means what? You don't execute all these statements and then till here you just break and then the following statement you execute. That is what happened in this case, in this particular case. It's printed Thursday, then it printed Friday, and after that particular Friday statement here, there is a break. So it just caused the program termination of the switch and then it went to the printf statement, that is end of the program. Later, when we added a break here, again, what happened? It found the match at the case 4. Thursday got printed. Since there is no break, it went ahead in the Friday. Friday also got printed. And then there is no break, means again it went to the next Saturday. After printing Saturday, it found that there is a break. Break means now you skip, don't further execute. Means it came out of the switch and then it printed end of the program. That is what we got in the next instance, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. Now again, suppose if I remove this break here, what may happen? It will print Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then Sunday as well. After printing on the Sunday, break is there. Means you print only up to Sunday and then break means you skip this one. Now, suppose if I comment this also, if I comment this break also, then what may happen?
It will also print invalid, sir.
It will also print invalid, right? Let us check it. Okay, I just compile the program and then run it. Enter 4. Look at here. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, invalid number. All these statements got executed. Even if I comment this break, what may happen? After that, there are no lines, so further nothing will happen if I comment or if I leave the statement. Because break means you complete the switch. Here it is the switch and it will complete. No statements, so it will execute. Are you following this one? The what actually does break will in the switch case scenario, break will cause termination of switch case execution. The further statements of the switch case will be terminated. If I again bring back here, suppose if I bring back here, this comment, that is the, if I uncomment the line in the case 4, the break statement, and if I enter the Thursday, if I enter the value to be 4, what will happen now? Okay, now I have made what? Case 4, I have added the break statement, and if I run the program and I enter the value 4, what will happen? What is the output?
Only Thursday will be printed, sir.
Only Thursday will be printed, sir.
Only Thursday? Any other answers?
Thursday will be printed, sir.
Okay, just check it. Compile the program and then run enter 4. Only Thursday is printed. Very good. That means why it has printed only Thursday? After writing printing the Thursday, this statement, next statement is break. Break means you skip further execution. Okay, now two things to understand about the break statement in the switch case context. The first one is break is not mandatory, right? Is it mandatory to write the break? Mandatory means with respect to the syntax we are talking here. If I don't write break, it will not give any compilation error. It is absolutely fine. But why we make use of the break? We want to stop the execution there itself. We don't want to go into the another values. Because of that, we write the break statement. Second is what? The break will cause termination. Termination in the sense, the further statements of which belongs to these switch cases will not be executed as soon as the break is executed, and the control, the flow of execution will fall out of the switch statement. That means it will come to the next statements after this closing bracket. Is that clear, students? Any doubts? Please ask questions if you have any doubts, because it is important to understand. Okay, we'll take a few more examples, okay, and then we will again work upon the switch.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, if we use, sir, not about this. I am not having doubt about this program, sir. Just I want to see if int you have written as int main, and at the end, if we do not write the return zero, what kind of error it will print, sir? To see that.
Let us do that. Right? I'm commented the return zero and then clear this, compile the program. Okay, no errors. When you run the program also, say 4, no errors. Now, in certain compilers, as I said earlier, there are different compilers. Okay, now in certain compilers, when we don't mention this return zero, okay, and we have added the int main, that time the program will not compile successfully. It will throw error. It will say that the main function is not returning any value. Okay, return statement is missing. We get that type of error in some of the compilers. And in some of the compilers, even though if you don't mention the return zero, it will successfully compile the program and without any errors. That can also be done. In this one, the compiler which I am using here, it is not giving any of the errors. Let us check it in any one of the online compilers. Let's see online GDB for C compilers. Let us check it over here. Okay, I got a ready-made program here. Let us here also what we see, int main is there and then return zero. Let us comment this return zero and then run the program. Does it give any error? Let us check. No, it is not giving any error. So certain compilers will not throw any errors, but in some of the compilers, the old age compilers, when we compile the program without writing the return zero and int main provided, sometime it will give the errors. Okay, we will discuss what is this int main, why it is the int value and why we are returning zero in the later sessions. During that time, you will get a better picture about why we are mentioning the return values and all. Okay. But make a habit of whenever you write int main, you should write return zero. Because in theory subjects, in the theory exams, suppose if you write an int main and if you don't write a return zero, there is a chance that you don't get a full marks, even though you would have written the code correctly. If you don't write a return zero, there is a chance that your marks will be reduced by one. Okay. We'll discuss on that one in the later stages. Are you making use of this online compilers for writing the programs and executing? Are you doing that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, fine. Now, I think it's been now around 20-25 minutes we have started with the class. I have blocked the entering into this particular meeting. Means class, I know that few students are joining the class at the late moment after 30 minutes and all, just to enter the roll numbers. Now I have blocked it, means nobody will be able to attend the class now. Even if you come out, if you exit from the meeting, then you will also not get a chance to attend it back. Okay. Yes, let us go to our program and let's try to work upon few more examples. Okay. Let me take up a new another program. Shall I give one homework for you, as in the same way how we had written for the day number and corresponding days? Can you write a similar program wherein it will ask you to enter again a number? Based upon the number, you need to display the month, right? January to December, there are total 12, right? So you should require 12 different cases from 1 to 12 and a default one. Will you be able to do that?
Yes, sir.
Read a number and corresponding month of the year you need to print it. That's it. Okay, then let us go to the next another program. Write a C program to calculate area of different shapes, different geometrical shapes. Let me save the program first. The program is 18 here, 18 dot switch areas dot C. Okay. So what we're going to do here is that we will display something like this. Let me write a multi-line comment here and then explain what should happen when we execute the program. When I execute the program, it should display saying that menu, it should display a menu, then one number one dot area of circle, two dot area of rectangle, three dot area of say triangle. Okay, then let's have one more area of square as well. Fine. Okay, then when we execute the program, we should get this menu, like this menu, and then area one, area of circle, two, area of rectangle, three, area of triangle, four, area of a square. What actually it means? It means that later you will be having a statement saying, enter your choice. Okay, then cursor will be waiting here. Now, suppose if I enter a one number, what it should do is that it should ask me to enter a radius and then calculate area of a circle. Okay, suppose if I enter two here, then for rectangle, I require two sides, length and breadth. Then it should ask me to enter length and breadth, then calculate the area of a rectangle and then display it. And if I enter a three here, it should ask me to calculate the area of a triangle. Area of a triangle can be calculated in a different ways, right? A simplest form is what? Reading the length and, the base and length. Using the length and base, we can calculate and display it. And the square, I require only one side. So if I enter a one side, then it should calculate the area of a square and then display. Suppose if I enter any other number like a seven and all, it should display that you have entered invalid choice. Then program should get terminated. So this way we are going to design and write the program. Is that program understood, the concept what we are going to write for?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let us write hash include stdio.h. Okay, now students, if the meeting gets completed, okay, by at 40, I mean after 40 minutes, quickly join back. Okay, because I want to complete this program, another 10-15 minutes I may extend it here. So attendance will be taken later itself in the second session, not in this particular session. Okay, if the program, I'm taking more time, if definitely it will cross more than 40 minutes. So second time when you immediately join in, during that time I will take the attendance, not this session. Okay. In yes. Main, that means don't log off now and join later. You are losing your valuable time here. Return zero. Fine. Now, what I want here, I want to display this type of menu item. So I should write a printf statement to handle this one. Okay, that I can do. But before that, I need to declare the variables, right? So for circle, rectangle, triangle, and a square, I need a different variables. Right. So let me have variables here. First variable is for what? The circle. For the circle, radius I need to have. So radius, what type of data type we should use? Integer or a float?
Float.
Float, right?
Float.
Float, say R. R here is for the radius. Okay. Then when I calculate the area of a circle, then again I get a variable, right? So for that, I need to use again a float value. So I will mention it to be area of C. Area of C means it is an area of a circle. See here.
So we have to define the value of pi.
Yeah, we will do that also. We will do that also. Okay. Now area underscore C I have used, right? If I use a space here, then it will give a compilation error. To avoid that one, I will use this underscore, right? So we will use define the pi also. So hash define pi 3.142. Fine. Then next, we need the variables for now rectangle. So for rectangle, shall we use the integer variables?
Yes, sir.
So for rectangle, we need what, two sides, isn't it? So shall I mention it to be S1? So S1 and S2 are for what? Rectangle sides. Then for triangle, we need base and height, right? Base and height we require. So I will use B and H. Is that fine? Okay. Then we need square. What we require? We require only one side, right? So for the square, I will use it to be S. Okay. Then for storing the area of a rectangle, so I will go with the same convention, area underscore R for the rectangle, area underscore T for the triangle, then area underscore S for the square. Now, let me know if there are any confusions of between this particular variable declaration. Are there any confusions? Any difficulties? Let me give a quick recap. R is for radius. Area C means area of a circle. S1 and S2 are for two sides of the rectangle. B and H are for the base and the height for the triangle. Then S is for what? Square, side of a square. Then correspondingly three different areas for the rectangle, triangle and a square. Okay, now after doing this one, what we need to do, we need to display the menu in this format, right? So what we can do is that let us write the printf statement, printf, right? Within the double quotes, I will write certain stars here, then menu. Again, few more stars, slash n, double quote complete, and the semicolon. So what will happen? It will just print the menu in this particular format. Then printf. So what I need to write now? One for what? Area of circle. Area of circle. Slash n, double quote complete, close the bracket, semicolon. In the same way, I will write few more, that is, this 2 is for area of rectangle. Then 3 is for area of triangle. Then 4 is for area of square. Isn't it? Now, after that, what I need to do? Enter your choice, right? So what I will write? I will write one more printf statement here. Printf. Enter your choice. Okay, then double quote complete and semicolon. Now, since I want to choose the, I want to store the choice also, or one particular value. That value will be of data type 1, 2, 3, 4, means integer data type. That means I require one more variable here, right? I require one more variable. So let me write it to be a choice. I will write it to be a choice now. So what this choice means, this particular choice is integer data type where I'm going to store the corresponding value what I type for, right? Then in order to read the choice, I need to write a statement scanf, scanf percentage d, because it is an integer value and I want to store into the choice variable. So ampersand choice. Is that understood till here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now suppose choice value. Yes, any questions?
Sir, instead of using area C as we as a default as the break statement works, sir, we can take a single area instead of taking as area C, area R, area T, area S.
Yes, we can do that also, but I just kept it a simple so that when we write the programs, further programs, then we can try to shrink our program. We can reduce our program. So as of now, I'm keeping it as separate areas only, separate variables. Even we can do that same thing for the sites also. We don't need to have all these variables, but making it more understandable as we are writing it the first type of a program, let it be, later we can get rid of all those things. Okay, fine.
Thank you, sir.
We need to have a switch cases, right? So switch, and in the switch here, what will be my expression? Here I need to write an expression. So what will be
choice?
Choice.
Choice. Yes, very good. Choice. Right. I know this choice is of integer data type, right? Then I need to write my corresponding case values. So case. So what will be the first? After writing case, what I should write?
Enter one. The radius of the circle.
Case one colon.
Case one colon.
Case one
colon.
And here I need to write corresponding state. So one is for what purpose?
Printf.
Of a circle.
Printf.
Area of circle. First I need to read the radius, right? So statement should be what? Printf. Enter.
The radius of the circle.
Enter radius. Okay, I'm just keeping it a simple. Enter radius or a enter radius of a circle. Fine. Then close the bracket. Then this. Then we need to read that value. So scanf. Since it is what type of data? What is the data type of the radius?
Float. Percentage.
Then percentage F. Percentage F. Then ampersand, it should get stored in R variable. Right? So now we write the radius here. Then next is what? We need to calculate the area. Then what is the corresponding variable for area of circle? It is area underscore C equals to. What is the formula?
Pi r square.
Pi r square. Pi into r into
r. R into r.
R.
So input is done. Then next calculation is done. And the next step is what? Output it. So output means printf. Okay. Area of circle equals to percentage f again. Then slash n double quote complete. Then corresponding variable, that is area underscore
area.
Area underscore c. Followed here. Then next statement is what? Break. So we want to break it here. So the break statement. Then correspondingly, we need to design our code for the next case also. Case 2 is for what purpose? It is for the rectangle. So printf, enter two sides of a rectangle. Two sides of a rectangle. Double quote complete, close the bracket, semicolon. Then store it into a variables. What are the variables here? What is the data type?
Integer.
Integer. So percentage d. How many percentage d I need to type?
2%.
Then so what are the those two values here? Variables. Ampersand S1, ampersand S2. Close the bracket, semicolon. So input is done. Next is what? Calculation. So calculation, area of rectangle equals to. What is the formula?
S1 into S2.
Yes.
Length into
breadth.
S1 into S2.
Semicolon. Next, print that. So print f area of rectangle equals to percentage d slash n double quote complete comma area underscore r rectangle. Semicolon. Then break, then break statement. Yes. So two cases we had written already. Third is for what? Area of a triangle. Okay, let's write that corresponding code also. So case, this time it will be a 3, then a colon. Then what I need to write? Print f, enter, base, and what usually we call base and height, or base or a length?
Height.
Height.
Height, sir.
Height of a triangle. Okay, colon, and then I will write it. Fine. Scanf. So, what are the data type for height and base? It is integer. So, %d, double quote complete. Then, so what are the variables we have declared? It is b and h. So, b and h means ampersand b, first one is the base, then ampersand
h. Height.
Right? Okay, semicolon. Next. Now, tell me, what is the formula for triangle?
Half into base into height.
Half into base into height. That half, can I rate it to
half
be?
Half into base into height.
0.5 right?
Into base into height.
Into height. Now, just look at here. The area what we get for the triangle, it will be in the form of what? Fractional values. Right. Correct? Fractional values. But the data type here, area T, is in the form of values. So isn't that we need to make a modification here? So what I will do is that I will take this area triangle and I will put it into here area as a float values. Is that understood now? Why I made this change? Because area of a triangle may have a fractional values. So in order to store that, I'm just keeping it to be a floating point number. Okay, then next is, so printf area of triangle equals to percentage. What here? Is it a D or a F now?
Yep.
Yep. Yep.
Percentage F. Slash and double quote complete, comma, area T. T for your triangle. Okay. Then break statement. Case 4. Printf, this case 4 is for what? The square. Enter a side of square. Right? Then read that particular value. Turn off the videos. Drakshayani. Scanf. Now, only one variable, integer type. So, percentage D. Then next is ampersand S. I think S is the variable. Okay, then formula for area of a square, area of S is equals to side into side. Correct? Then print that. So print F area of square equals to percentage D slash N, then area of square. Printing it and then breaks it. Okay. Now tell me what I should do in the next statements. We have written all the corresponding cases. What we need to
write? Default. In the printf invalid choice.
Printf
invalid choice.
Yes. Very good.
Sir, in the case 3, sir.
In case 3,
sir, what scanf. Scan a percentage of and percentage of.
Okay. What are the, now let us check it here. B and H. So B and H are what type of data type we have declared? It is a integer values. So it is perfect if I use it to be integer. Only the area of a triangle, I change it to float, because the formula here, when you look into the formula, in the formula we have a fractional numbers. That means the area may have a fractional values. So I'm just changing the data type of the area only, not the base and height. Base and height, I'm just keeping it to be an integer only. So this is percentage D, percentage D. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So here, after this break, we can write the break here or we may skip also. If I skip, what will happen? Next, immediately that there is a closing of the switch case. So if I write or if I don't write, that is fine. Nikhil, turn off your video. Okay, let us.
Sorry, sir.
Yeah, it's okay, no worries. It may happen. Let us run the program. Clear. Okay, GCC, and the program number was what, 18 here. So 18 run. Let's see. Wow, we didn't get any compilation error. That's really good, students. You have told me all the statements, and according to that, I had written here. Very good. Now let us see whether there are program is executing as per we designed or some there are any logical errors. Run the program. Okay. Now menu, area of circle, 2 area of rectangle, 3 area of triangle, 4 area of a square. Enter your choice. Let me enter 7 here. What is expected? If I enter 7,
invalid choice.
Invalid,
right? So, invalid choice. Very good. Let us execute once again. This time, let me enter 1. Now, it is see here, enter radius of a circle. So, let me enter the radius as 3.5. Area of circle is 38.488. So, it is working correctly. Let us execute it once again. This time, let me enter 2 here for the rectangle. Enter 2 sides of a rectangle, say 4 and 6. Area of rectangle is 24, that is 4 into 6, that is correct again. Let us execute once again for the option 3. I will enter 3. 3 is for the triangle. So base and height. So base let it be 4 and height let it be 5. We are getting 10.0000. Right? This time it is giving a correct values. If I have other values where to store the this fractional part, say if I have 3 and 5, definitely it will have 7.5. That is also correct. Let us run it for the last set of values for the square. Fourth, I am pressing 4 means it is for the square. Enter a side of a square. So let us say 8. So 8 is a 64. If I enter any other values, look at here. If I enter a 100 also or a 1000 also, what will happen? Invalid choice. So the program what we had written here, it is executing as per our the given problem. We are successfully able to write a program wherein it will ask user to choose one of the options here. Now think here, in the yesterday's class I had given you one example, right? Related to the mobile balance and all those things. You just visualize, there will be definitely one code which where they would have written a print statement. Will print these options. Whenever you choose that number, corresponding case value will get executed. Suppose if the one is for the balance, there would be a case one, and in case one, there will be certain statements which will retrieve the balance in your account number. If case two was, suppose if it is for the purpose of special offers, then when the corresponding case two will be having some data related to the offers which they give for the your number, like that, then there will be a different case values. Now, anywhere, now onwards, if anytime in any of the softwares or any applications, if you find the menus like this, menus, we call it to be a menu items, right? If you find menu items, that means that particular application or the software or the program definitely had made use of switch cases to give the application experience in that way. Is it interesting? The switch case is interesting to learn?
Yes, sir.
Understood the concept now? What a switch case and is?
Yes, sir.
Now, suppose if I remove this break statement at case one, if I remove this break statement case one, and if I, let me compile it, GCC, and this is 18, okay, and then execute. And if I press one, what will happen? See?
It will also show area of rectangle.
So 3.5 area of circle will get calculated. Then immediately you can see here, enter two sides of a rectangle. That means what? It has executed this one. Then it has started with the next set of statement execution. Since there was no break, it just continued like that. So now again, I will have to enter the values. Then it will calculate. Then it will terminate here because there is a break here. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Another simple concept. If I don't have this default, if I don't have this particular default, what will happen? Okay, let's see here. I don't have a default. Now I enter option 8. Nothing happened, right? It did not give us a message for us that we have entered an invalid number. whenever user enters, apart from these case values, if we want, if we wish to display a particular message, then such messages have to be handled in the default cases. Okay, so enter your attendance, students. Meanwhile, enter the attendance. If there are any questions, you can ask now.
Sir, using this, I have yesterday you taught switch and guesses. Sir, using this, I have written a program to as a simple calculator where we can perform addition, subtraction.
Yes.
Simple calculators program. Yes.
Okay. Very good. Very good. So, did you get a proper output?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just opening your syllabus. There is one journal program. I will go through this journal from tomorrow onwards. This is we can calculate program to enter PTR and then calculate simple interest. I think we have covered this one already, right? Then write a program to check whether a year is leap year or not. Okay, quickly note down the homework for you. You no need to write the programs. Only I want you to find the years which are leap years and which are not leap years. How to calculate, how to find out whether a particular year is a leap year or not, how to do that one, you find it out. Then tomorrow's class, we will try to implement that, okay? Then program to find GCD, right? Greatest common divisor, that we will try to work it out. Then next is, this concept is not yet covered. We can keep it aside. This all are array. Okay, then there is one program here. Look at here, program number 7. Write a program to find, write a program to function as a basic calculator. It should ask user to input what type of arithmetic operation would like and then ask for the numbers on which the operation should be performed. The calculator should then give the output of the operation. Use switch. Error message should be reported if any attempt is made to divide by 0. Let's do one thing. In tomorrow's class, let me take up this particular program because it is continuation of the switch case. We will try to work on the calculator. We will try to write a menu item like this, the way how we have designed here. It should display plus, minus, multiplication, that is star, and then division. If we choose any of those operation, it should perform that particular operation. And look at the statement here. Error message should be reported if any attempt is made to divide by 0. Means for the division, if the second number, that is denominator, is 0, then it should not calculate the division. It should not perform the division operation. Instead of that, it should mention the message that you have entered the 0. So further calculation will not be done. So we'll try to go through this one. Meantime, you can just find out the concept of what a leap year, how to calculate, and also GCD of two numbers. These two also, you just try to find the solutions, not through writing the programs, in general methods. Okay. I hope each one of you entered the attendance.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's conclude the class here. If there are any doubts related to the switch case, note it down, and in tomorrow's class, you can ask.